हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी माउर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर जूलॉजी, श्री सांवलिया जी गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज, मंडफिया, चित्तौड़गढ़। टुडे माय टॉपिक इज वाटर पोल्यूशन, एंड इन दिस लेक्चर आई डिस्कस व्हाट आर द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ वाटर पोल्यूशन, हाउ कैन वाटर पोल्यूशन कैन बी कंट्रोल्ड, एंड व्हाट आर द एफिडमेंट्स रिलेटेड टू वाटर पोल्यूशन। Water pollution is the contamination of water bodies, and it occurs when pollutants are discharged directly or indirectly into water bodies like lakes, rivers, oceans, aquifer, and the groundwater, and without adequate treatment to remove harmful compounds. So, effects of water pollution. Water pollution. When pathogen contaminates the water, it causes water pollution. And this pathogen contaminated water is responsible for many infectious diseases like jaundice, typhoid, hepatitis, etc. Industrial water is also responsible for affecting human health badly. When the people get exposed to arsenic, it causes black foot disease in them, or it may also cause diarrhea, lung and skin cancer. The asbestos fiber causes a lung disease, which is known as asbestosis. When nitrates exceeds above 90 ppm, it causes cyanosis or blue babies in people. When cadmium poisoning takes place, it causes iti disease. Iti disease is a painful joint and bones disease. Skeletal fluorosis or knock-knee disease also caused due to excess of fluorides. Minamata disease, have you heard about it? In Japan, in 1952, this disease appeared due to consumption of mercury-contaminated fishes of Minamata Bay. Mercury, lead, methyl mercury, they all are neurotoxic in nature. Then, poor quality water is not good for drinking. It's unfit for drinking, industrial and recreational purposes. When water gets polluted by radioactive elements, it may destroy biological immune system and may cause somatic genetic disorder, and it may also cause gene mutation in living organism. When nitrates get exceed because of fertilizers, phosphates from detergents and organic matter from domestic effluents, it increases productivity of lake, pond or river. And this increased productivity of water bodies due to nutrient enrichment is called eutrophication. Surface runoff and the warm water from thermal plant and nuclear reactor also causes eutrophication. Eutrophication leads to thick bloom of algae. It causes suffocation in aquatic organisms. It degrades water quality. It may cause reduction in number of fishes, and it increases BOD, that is biological oxygen demand. Then hot water of thermal plant and nuclear reactor decreases the decomposition of organic waste, and it may kill the aquatic organism. Because of the sudden change in temperature of water, it affects hatching of eggs. So it may cause early hatching of eggs in fishes, and it may also cause failure of trout egg to hatch, and may cause failure of salmon to spawn. Then oil spill, it damage marine biodiversity, and it also cause damage to coral reef. Then biomagnification or biological concentration is also one of the effect of water pollution. Persistent pesticides. through surface runoff are passed into food chain and it causes biomagnification. The known biodegradable pollutants are not decomposed by microorganisms and they get accumulated in tissue in increasing concentration along the food chain, and this process is called biomagnification. There are many ill effects of biomagnification. DDT interferes eggshell formation in many birds. Minamata disease also because of biomagnification of mercury. So it is a very a bad effect on water. Biomagnification, it may cause many ill effects in living organisms. Then groundwater. Groundwater contamination is a reversible. Once it is contaminated, it is very difficult to restore the original water quality of the aquifer. And as we know, it is reversible, but it will take long time. Very, very long time. Human activities are adding industrial, domestic and agricultural water to groundwater reservoir at an alarming rate. So it may affect human as well as living organisms in a near future. So these are the effects of water pollution. Now, water quality standards. There is a dissolved oxygen, that is DO, biological oxygen demand, BOD, and the chemical oxygen demand, COD. They are important parameters in the assessment of water quality. Quantitative measurements of pollutants are very necessary before water pollution can be controlled. So first is dissolved oxygen, that is DO. So water with dissolved oxygen below 8.0 mg per liter may be considered as a contaminated, and below 4.0 mg per liter is heavily polluted. The amount of oxygen dissolved in water is usually measured by Winkler dissolved oxygen test. By this test, we can estimate dissolved oxygen. Then BOD, that is biological oxygen demand. It is an indirect measure of water quality. It measures amount of oxygen which is required for biological oxidation of microbes in any unit volume of water at 20 degrees Celsius in 5 days. When higher is the amount of oxygen consumed, greater is the degree of organic pollutants, and the water with higher BOD cannot be utilized as it can spread infectious diseases. Then chemical oxygen demand, that is COD. It is also an indirect measure of water quality. It is a measure of amount of oxygen which is required to oxidize all the pollutants. It may be biodegradable or non-biodegradable. In any unit volume of water at 20 degrees Celsius in 5 days, the volume of COD is always higher than BOD. When there is a higher volume of COD, greater is the water pollution. So these are the water quality standards. Then control and abatements. So as we know, what industrial waste water has many hazardous substances. So if it is discharged into municipal sewage system, it will affect the whole ecosystem, water ecosystem. So it should be strictly controlled. There must be strict regulation for industrial effluents or waste, and that they must not discharge highly toxic water into water bodies. Industrial and municipal wastewater should be treated in effluent treatment plant, that is ETP, before they are discharged into water bodies. It involves three types of treatment. So First is primary treatment. It is a physical process by which large debris are separated by sedimentation and mechanical screening. In this treatment, wastewater after screening is allowed to pass through grit chamber where sand, grit and other solids gets settled down. And when the screen is completed, water is allowed to pass through sedimentation tank or clarifier in which most of the suspended solids settle down because of gravity. Then second is a secondary treatment. It is a biological process. In this method, oxidation of organic matter is done with the help of microorganisms. Microorganism is bacteria, algae. They break down the organic matter into harmless materials like carbon dioxide and water. Trickling filter and activated sludge methods are used for secondary treatment. Then third is a tertiary treatment. It is a physiochemical process. It removes turbidity from wastewater. In this treatment, oxidation of wastewater is done by strong oxidizing agents like chlorine gas, percolate salts, ozone and UV rays. Then there are also some techniques like adsorption, electrodialysis process, ion exchange method and reverse osmosis. These methods are also used for the removal of biological, chemical and radioactive water pollution. Then chemicals like potassium permanganate should be spread regularly in order to protect water from microorganisms, and it is used for the control of pollution which occurs due to phosphorus, lime, ferric chloride. It precipitates a phosphate. Then detergents with low phosphate should be used because these add pollution and cause eutrophication. So we should not use detergents with high phosphate level. Then afforestation should be encouraged in order to reduce surface runoff. Then algae and other waterborne vegetation should be cleaned regularly in water bodies. It will check recycle of nutrients into the water and prevent eutrophication. Then integrated pest management technique should be encouraged because it will maintain control over pest, reduce reliance on chemical pesticides, and it will protect water quality. Then recycling of waste should be encouraged, like use of gobar gas plant, recycling of agricultural waste, composting. They all can prevent water pollution to some extent. Then thermal pollution can be checked by employing heat or drying cooling towers. And then there should be control on oil spills at sea. There is a need to transfer oil from a tanker which has been involved in accident to another vessel which used tanker's own pump or suction pump of the reserve vessel, and to limit the amount of spill transferring. So by this process, oil spills can be controlled at sea. Then there are some abatements like the Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1981. This act deals with the preservation of water quality and control water pollution with the concern for detrimental effects of water pollutants on human health. So these are some control and abatements. Water pollution. So in today's lecture, I described what are the effects of water pollution, in which I gave main emphasis on यूट्रोफिकेशन एंड बायोमैग्निफिकेशन और बायोलॉजिकल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. देन वाटर क्वालिटी स्टैंडर्ड्स. आई डिस्कस थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट पैरामीटर्स विच आर यूज इन द असेसमेंट ऑफ वाटर क्वालिटी. दीज आर डिजॉल्व्ड ऑक्सीजन डीओ, बायोलॉजिकल ऑक्सीजन डिमांड बीओडी एंड केमिकल ऑक्सीजन डिमांड सीओडी. देन हाउ कैन वाटर पॉल्यूशन बी कंट्रोल्ड. सो देयर आई डिस्क्राइब ट्रीटमेंट ऑल्सो. हाउ कैन इंडस्ट्रियल एंड म्युनिसिपल वेस्ट ट्रीटेड इन एफ्लुएंट ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट्स बिफोर देयर डिस्चार्ज इनटू वाटर बॉडीज. एंड इट वॉल्स दैट इन्वॉल्व्स थ्री ट्रीटमेंट, प्राइमरी, सेकेंडरी, टर्शरी. प्राइमरी इज अ फिजिकल प्रोसेस, सेकेंडरी इज अ बायोलॉजिकल प्रोसेस एंड टर्शरी इज अ फिजियोकेमिकल प्रोसेस. देन देर आर सम टेक्निक्स लाइक एड्सॉर्प्शन, इलेक्ट्रोडायलिसिस, आयन एक्सचेंज एंड रिवर ऑस्मोसिस. एंड डिटर्जेंट्स विथ लो फॉस्फेट शुड बी यूज्ड. एफॉरेस्टेशन, रिसाइकलिंग ऑफ वेस्ट, इंटीग्रेटेड पेस्ट मैनेजमेंट, दीज शुड बी इनकरेज्ड. देन देर इज़ अ वन लीगल कंट्रोल, दैट इज़ अ वाटर प्रिवेंशन एंड कंट्रोल ऑफ पॉल्यूशन एक्ट 1981. Thank you.